Hey, it's Joe Ferrer from Geek Toolkit, and today I'm going to show you how to take some of the graphs that we've been building off of our home automation system using Home Assistant and integrating them into a magic mirror. I love magic mirrors, and I think that they're very, very useful for what I call glance and go data. When I walk up to my magic mirror, as you can see here, I can get my temperature immediately. I can see wind speeds and sunrises. I can get stuff like the forecast for the next week. I can look and see the traffic. I can see the health of the magic mirror, the time and date. But now also I can pull in data from my home automation system and get things like the climate, such as humidity and temperatures, or I can get my internet health as my download speeds. And so this becomes a really, really cool walk up and get data. And the way that I did this, I think, is a lot cooler as far as the full Grafana graphs get rendered here. So as beautiful as you want to make your Grafana graph, anything you want to pull data from, I'm going to show you how to get it into your magic mirror in this tutorial. Now there's going to be two main parts of this. There's going to be the Home Assistant and Grafana side, and then there's going to be the magic mirror side. Now if you haven't watched my last two videos about Grafana, please go back and watch those, because that's where I show you how to set up InfluxDB and set up Grafana. In the second tutorial, I talk about how to build a system dashboard. This is where I talk about how to get CPU usage and how to get the speedtest.net data in. From here, I'm going to assume that you have those dashboards built and you're kind of comfortable with Grafana. And we're going to talk about how to get them into a playlist. And then we'll talk about how to get that into Magic Mirror. So let's get started. Here's the Pi dashboard that I built in the last video, talking about how to do system management stuff. Now, the thing about this is, this is fine if I'm going to have all four show up on my magic mirror, but if you look at my magic mirror setup, it's actually split out to the sides here so that I've got a mirror part. Keep in mind, this is going to be reflective, and I want part of it to reflect me because it is a mirror that I'm going to use. So I throw my data out to the outside. In that spirit, I want my charts to be a lot smaller, but I also want to do this playlist approach where it will go through each chart one after another. The way to do that is in Grafana, if you go to playlists, you see here we can create a playlist out of dashboards. Now, one thing to note to set this up is you're going to want your dashboards to be set up in such a way that you only have one chart per dashboard, and you're going to want to have the settings to have values down here. It'll be a lot easier to view. Once you've set up your dashboards like that, then when we go to playlists, and we create a new playlist. Let's see here, we'll just do, we give it a name. This interval here, you can do M for minutes or you can do S for seconds. For this demo, we'll do 8 seconds. That's what it looks like. And then all we have to do is add the dashboards that we want. So I've got a couple here I've created where I've taken out the Pi dash and split them up to CPU, download speed, and so on. So let's just add three of these here. Very simple, you can add them, you can figure out what order you want them to show up in, and then we say create. And there we go, we've got our video demo dashboard. Now we're gonna test it real quick. We're gonna say view, and we'll do kiosk mode with auto fit panels. And then just wait 10 seconds and make sure that this goes from one view to another view. That's all we have to do. So there we go. Okay, so our dashboard's cycling. Now, to get the playlist URL, which we need from up here, we're going to go back into Grafana and we're going to go to playlists. Now, this start playlist, we're going to right click. Oh, sorry. We're going to click on it and then right click and say copy link address. Basically, we want that URL that is there. Not this one. This one here, if you copy and paste this, you will only get the CPU usage dashboard. If you look, they're slightly different. Okay, now I'm VNC'd into the Magic Mirror, and I'm going to show you how to install the module for MMM-iframe. That module is right here on Git, and this part I'm about to do next, if you haven't installed things on Magic Mirror, then this is how it's done and it will be useful. It's basically the same pattern for any of the third-party modules for Magic Mirror. So the first thing you want to do is get the git clone URL, and then you're going to go to your Mirror here, and you're gonna go to your modules folder. Now your modules folder is in Magic Mirror, and then it's gonna be in modules. And then in here, you can see these are all my plugins. So all I will do is call git clone, and I would paste the git clone address here, and it will pull it down and put it into mmm-iframe. Now I already have this, so I'm expecting this to, already exists. That's fine. If that were to come down, then the next thing you would do is go up a directory and go to configs. And then from here, you'd go sudo, I use leafpad because it's just easy, config.js, and now you can edit in your module. For any module, if you look through here, you'll find the basically an example and what parameters you can put in. For this one here, I have MMM iframe, let's see. I have it right here. And so this URL is going to be the URL of the playlist that we copied off. So now that I've got the config.js updated, I can close that out. And again, the other nice thing about LeafPad is if you're pasting in the VNC, it makes it a little bit easier to paste that in there. So here's the problem. If I launch Magic Mirror using the Electron UI that it normally uses, it won't be able to authenticate. So for instance, if I open up Chromium here and I were to paste that address in that we're going to use, you'll see that authentication may fail on this. And now we got to the unauthorized error that I was trying to get past. So I wanted to show you this because this is one of the errors that you'll hit. And this is one of the big tricks that I had to figure out how to get past. So to get past this, we're going to go to the Home Assistant URL / the Grafana portion. And we'll wait to get authenticated here. Once this authenticates, the session cookie will get set for Grafana. We're going to say we want to save the login. And then when we go over here, Grafana shows up. It's kind of annoying because if nothing shows up here, that means that your authentication is wrong. You won't get an error. You'll simply see nothing. There's one final thing we have to do now. We have to tell Magic Mirror when it starts up to start up the backend server and then start up Chrome in full screen, which is if I hit F11, it'll show up like this to go to full screen, basically kiosk mode. And then this is exactly how we want things to go. So there's one more change we need to do. We're gonna sudo leafpad mm.sh to edit it, and we want it to look like this here. The first thing I do is kill off any other Chromium windows. I wanna get rid of them. The next thing is we're gonna have to cd to the Magic Mirror directory. And then we're gonna use node, and we're gonna set up Magic Mirror to start as server only. This ampersand will have it continue on to the next line. We're going to sleep to give the server a second to start up because we definitely need that server up and running before we go to the next line. This will start Chrome in kiosk mode, and it will pass it that Grafana page that I was showing you. Basically, this is automating what we just did where we navigate to the Grafana page. That'll set the session cookie and authenticate us. We're going to sleep for 25 seconds because that takes a little bit to get going, and we don't want this to mess up. The nice thing is it only has to do this for once on boot up anyway. Then we're gonna basically launch our Magic Mirror in kiosk mode, localhost 8080. So this is all the steps I just showed you automated on startup. If you have Magic Mirror installed and you have this mm.sh file, it's already set up to run on start. So then all we should have to do is sudo reboot. And when this comes back up, we should see the Magic Mirror startup. We'll see it log into the Grafana page, and then we will see the Magic Mirror start rendering. Okay, now after you reboot, you'll see the Magic Mirror is working as expected. We've got Grafana in the corner. It's full screen. Very beautiful. I'm very excited about this. This is what I call discrete technology, where it's not in your face. It's something that, for me, my mirror is off. When I walk up to it, it doesn't turn on until I'm near it. Other than that, it just looks like a mirror hanging on the wall. When it does turn on, though, I get some really powerful data being pulled from my home automation system. And I really appreciate that. I think that's really cool. I also get my weather and traffic. There's a couple of things I want to leave you with before I close this out that I think are important here. One is we're playing through a playlist, so we're playing through several dashboards. If you want to update the dashboards, you don't have to go through all of this again. Once you have those dashboards rendering here, you can actually go into your dashboard, click on it, and you can do things like manage it here. So if I wanted to add networking, I could just add that and system management, and now the playlist can be updated. I can also do things like the interval here. When I save that out, that playlist gets saved and updated, and it will get picked up here on the next, the next refresh, which I think is 30 seconds, it should pick it up. The other thing to know is because the Magic Mirror is using the server only, I can actually browse to my Magic Mirror's IP address, :8080, and have that data up anywhere. So I can have a dashboard now on any television or monitor. It doesn't have to be a Magic Mirror. If I have a little computer off to the side or a tablet not doing anything, and I want to have that same dashboard data available at all times, I can have that on my desk. If you look at the mini Magic Mirror project I did a while back, this is another great use of that. You can add the dashboards to that and have them just there on your desk on the corner and have, you know, your scrolling view there. So just a couple of other things to know about this setup and the power of it. I want to thank you for watching this. This is a video I've wanted to make for a really long time. I've been really excited about it, and I put a lot of work into it because my initial attempts all failed. There are a couple other methods to do this. If you're familiar with Nginx, you can do what's called a reverse proxy, and you can do the authentication that way. And of course, the final way to do this is just simply turn off authentication for Grafana entirely. Keep in mind, if you do that though, you may be exposing all of the data from your home automation system out in the open. And so I didn't feel comfortable having the Magic Mirror access it without some kind of authentication. I think this way here keeps the token alive. I've been running it for a couple weeks now and haven't had any problems. So I expect that this should be fine. If it ever did, all I'd have to do is VNC into it and re-authenticate and should be good to go. So thanks for watching. I'm Joe Farah with Geek Toolkit. And until next time, if you subscribe, I'll probably get into that Samsung The Frame TV next. Talk to you then.